listening to the dull black drone of the wind outside my window, and the sound of bare branches scraping against the shingles of the roof just above me. Soon my thoughts became fixed upon a town, picturing its various angles and aspects. A remote town near the northern border. Thank you. shalt not meddle. Thank you. Do you have a room?
Open your eyes and see your surprise.
Mr. Crumb, it's late and you have to be on your way. You have business across the border.
I heard the sound of something that I could not identify. An approaching racket that caused me to take refuge in a narrow passageway between a pair of high buildings. Nestled in this dark hiding place, I watched the street and listened as that nameless clattering grew louder. It was a medley of clanging and creaking, of groaning and croaking. A dull jangle of something unknown as it groped its way through the town. A chaotic parade in honor of some special occasion of delirium. The street that I saw beyond the narrow opening between the two buildings was now entirely empty. The only thing I could glimpse was a blur of high and low structures, which appeared to quiver slightly as the noise became louder and louder. The parade closing in, though from which direction I did not know. The formless clamor seemed to envelop everything around me. And then suddenly I could see a passing figure in the street. Dressed in loose white garments, it had an egg-shaped head, but was completely hairless and as white as paste. A clown of some kind, who moved in a way that was both casual and laborious, as if it were strolling underwater or against a strong wind, tracing strange patterns in the air with billowed arms and pale hands. It seemed to take forever for this apparition to pass through view. But just before doing so, it turned to peer into the narrow passage where I had secreted myself, and its greasy white face was wearing an expression of bland malevolence. Others followed the lead figure, including a team of ragged men who were harnessed like beasts and pulled long, bristling ropes. They also moved out of sight, leaving the ropes to waver slackly behind them. The vehicle to which these ropes were attached by means of enormous hooks rolled into the sea, its great wooden wheels audibly grinding the pavement of the street beneath them. It was a sort of platform with huge wooden stakes rising from its perimeter to form the bars of a cage. There was nothing to secure the wooden bars at the top, and so they wobbled with the movement of the parade. Hanging from the bars and rattling against them was an array of objects haphazardly tethered by cords and wires and straps of various kinds. I saw masks and shoes, household utensils and naked dolls, large bleached bones and the skeletons of small animals, bottles of coloured glass, the head of a dog with a rusty chain wrapped several times around its neck, and sundry scraps of debris and other things I could not name, all knocking together in a wild percussion. I watched and listened as that ludicrous vehicle passed by in the street. Nothing else followed it, and the enigmatic parade seemed to be at an end now. Merely a delirious noise fading into the distance. hear the singing, you will know it is time. When you hear the singing, you will know it is time. When you hear the singing, you will know it is time. When you hear the singing, you will know it is time. When you hear the singing, you will know it is time. When you hear the singing, you will know it is time. When you hear the singing, you will know it is time. When you hear the singing, you will know it is time. When you hear the singing, you will know it is time. When you hear the singing, you will know it is time. When you hear the singing, you will know it is time. When you hear the singing, started into wakefulness.
Thank you. Thank you.